In the rapidly evolving world of artificial intelligence, a monumental shift has just occurred, and surprisingly, it didn't originate from the tech giants you'd expect, like OpenAI or Google. Instead, a small, unassuming startup based in Singapore has quietly unleashed a new AI agent called HRM. This isn't just another incremental upgrade, it represents perhaps the most significant breakthrough in AI reasoning we've witnessed in years. What makes HRM so revolutionary isn't its size or the sheer volume of data it was trained on. In fact, it's quite the opposite. HRM is fundamentally different. It's a brain-inspired model that, against all odds, is consistently outperforming AI models many times its size. You see, the current generation of large language models, like ChatGPT, tackle complex problems by breaking them down into a sequence of steps. This chain of thought approach can be effective, but it has a critical vulnerability. One tiny error early in the sequence can derail the entire process, leading to a completely flawed result. HRM, however, takes an entirely different approach. It mimics the human brain's ability to think in iterative loops, and the results are truly astonishing. Now, I know what you might be thinking. Oh, another small model claiming to beat the giants. But this one genuinely lives up to the hype. HRM isn't a scaled-down large language model, nor is it a stripped-back version of a transformer. It's something entirely novel. It's designed to replicate the brain's layered, decision-making strategy and apply it directly to artificial intelligence reasoning. This unique architecture allows a model with an incredibly modest 27 million parameters to consistently outperform models boasting hundreds of millions, or even billions, of parameters. To put that into perspective, the very first GPT model, GPT-1, had 117 million parameters. HRM has less than a quarter of that. Yet, despite its diminutive size, it's outperforming powerhouses like Claude and even OpenAI's latest models on critical reasoning benchmarks. Most contemporary AI models, particularly large language models, rely heavily on what's known as chain of thought prompting. Essentially, it's like the AI is verbally talking itself through a problem, step by painstaking step. It sounds clever, and for many tasks, it works. But the inherent flaw is that if the AI commits even a single logical misstep anywhere in that chain, the entire answer unravels. It's like a domino effect, one wrong move and the whole structure collapses. HRM completely sidesteps this pitfall. It doesn't rely on the fragility of a sequential chain. Instead, it reasons in a manner far more akin to human cognition, by thinking strategically about the overall problem, and then executing its plan with incredible speed and efficiency. So, how does it achieve this remarkable feat? The secret lies in HRM's ingenious two-part architecture, where both components are constantly communicating and collaborating. There's a high-level planner and a low-level worker. Imagine the planner as the wise, strategic brain, the chess grandmaster. Its role is to meticulously map out the big picture, analyze the problem type, and formulate a high-level strategy. The worker, on the other hand, is the agile, fast processor, the skilled assistant or the rapid chess player. It takes direct orders from the planner and executes the actual tasks quickly and efficiently. These two distinct parts engage in a continuous, dynamic loop. The high-level module devises a plan. The low-level module then carries out that plan, feeding back the results to the planner. The planner then takes this feedback, refines its understanding, and updates its strategy based on what just happened. This constant back-and-forth iteration continues until the model confidently arrives at a definitive answer. This isn't merely a clever trick, it's deeply embedded into HRM's fundamental architecture, endowing it with an invaluable capability that most other models lack, an internal mechanism to self-check, refine, and correct its own reasoning process mid-execution. And the outcomes are nothing short of astounding. Consider the ARC AGI benchmark, often considered an IQ test for artificial intelligence. HRM scored an impressive 40.3%. To put that into perspective, Claude, a much larger and more widely known model, scored 21.2%, and even OpenAI's top mini model only managed 34.5%. These aren't minor differences, they're massive performance gaps. This is a tiny model, running on a single graphics processing unit, consistently outperforming some of the biggest names in AI when it comes to pure, raw reasoning power. Let's push this even further. HRM was rigorously tested on Sudoku puzzles, specifically the hard and extreme levels. It successfully solved a remarkable 55% of them. Now, want to guess how Claude or OpenAI's models fared on the same challenge? A resounding 0%. Not a single one. And then there's the maze challenge, navigating 30 by 30 grids. HRM found the optimal path in 74.5% of the tests, while the others, once again, scored 0. All of this incredible performance was achieved with a model trained on just 1,000 examples per task. There were no massive internet-scale datasets, no months-long pre-training periods. Guan Wang, one of the brilliant minds behind HRM, even stated that you could train it to a professional Sudoku solving level in just 2 GPU hours. 2 hours. That's not just efficient, it's truly groundbreaking. But HRM's significance extends beyond mere benchmark performance. Its unique design inherently addresses some profound, underlying problems that current transformer-based models continue to grapple with. Let's take a step back and look at how transformer-based large language models like GPT or Claude operate. They process information in a fixed number of steps for each output token. This means they apply the exact same amount of thinking, regardless of how easy or difficult the question is. They simply lack the ability to say, "Hey, this is a tough one, I need to think longer," or, "Let me go back and rethink this." Once they start generating a token, they're locked into that decision. It's akin to solving a complex math problem by writing down one number at a time with a permanent marker, without ever being able to pause, check your work, or go back to correct a mistake. HRM shatters this fundamental limitation. Its innovative two-level architecture grants it the flexibility to adapt the amount of reasoning it applies based directly on the complexity of the problem at hand. In fact, there's even an advanced version of HRM that leverages reinforcement learning to autonomously decide precisely how many iterations it needs for any given task. So, for straightforward questions, it might loop just a few times. For significantly harder problems, it intelligently loops more, dedicating more computational thought. This adaptive flexibility makes it vastly more akin to actual, human-like flexible thinking than anything we've witnessed to date. Furthermore, because of its unique structure, HRM also ingeniously sidesteps one of the most significant bottlenecks in AI training today, the notoriously complex and resource-intensive process of deep backpropagation through time. Most traditional models necessitate remembering and synchronizing partial derivatives across multiple layers and countless time steps. This process is incredibly memory-intensive, excruciatingly slow, and frankly, it's highly unlikely that biological brains actually operate this way. HRM, on the other hand, utilizes more localized gradient updates, which are dramatically easier to compute and far more biologically plausible. Now, does this technical detail matter in practical application? Absolutely. Less memory required means you can run more models simultaneously, or train existing models much faster with significantly fewer computational resources. Crucially, it also signifies that this technology scales incredibly well. You could theoretically run HRM on a standard laptop, or even seamlessly embed it into compact edge devices or autonomous robots. And that's precisely what Sapien, the startup behind HRM, is actively pursuing. They're already testing HRM in real-world healthcare applications, assisting in the diagnosis of rare diseases and in seasonal climate forecasting, where it has reportedly achieved astonishing accuracy rates of 97%. The team behind Sapien and HRM is itself a testament to the project's immense potential. It comprises former engineers and researchers from industry titans like DeepMind, Anthropic, DeepSeek, and even Elon Musk's xAI group. These are individuals who have been at the absolute vanguard of artificial intelligence innovation, and they are collectively betting on HRM's brain-inspired design to eventually transcend the current limitations of what we've come to expect from large language models. They aren't shy about their ambitions either. Guan Wang, one of the project leads, openly stated that true artificial general intelligence is about imbuing machines with human-level intelligence, and ultimately, beyond. He declared that, chain of thought prompting is just a shortcut. What we've built is something that can truly think. Such bold confidence might typically be dismissed as mere hype, but in HRM's case, the empirical results unequivocally back up these extraordinary claims. And you don't just have to take their word for it. The entire project is open source, fully available for inspection on GitHub right now. You can delve into its code, train your own version, modify it, and witness its incredible capabilities firsthand. This level of transparency is incredibly rare, especially for a technology with such immense promise. Of course, it's still very early days for HRM. It currently maintains a relatively narrow focus. It's designed to reason, not to engage in casual conversation. So, don't expect it to write you a poignant poem or summarize your daily emails just yet. However, as a profound proof of concept, it stands as one of the most compelling and robust advancements we have seen in artificial intelligence. HRM isn't an isolated anomaly either. There are other fascinating architectural breakthroughs being explored across the AI landscape. Companies like Sakana are working on continuous thought machines, while other research explores vital large language models that utilize ultra-efficient single-bit weights. Even Google is experimenting with diffusion-based reasoning models. All of these pioneering efforts, while still in their experimental phases, are part of a shared, burgeoning trend. A fundamental rethinking of how artificial intelligence should actually function, rather than simply making existing models bigger and bigger. What sets HRM apart is that it's not just theory, it's already working. It's already demonstrating superior performance, beating models 4 times its size, utilizing a tiny fraction of the training data, and without any pre-training whatsoever. The implications are enormous. Unless someone suddenly pours billions into constructing a new foundational model from scratch, the next truly monumental leap in AI likely won't be another scaled-up version of GPT. It will be something like HRM, a completely novel architecture that ushers in an era of superior reasoning, dramatically faster training cycles, and far cheaper deployment, all without demanding a warehouse full of power-hungry graphics processing units. If HRM continues on its current trajectory, it could very well be the foundational first step towards a future where intelligent AI agents don't solely reside in massive data centers. Instead, they could live on your laptop, operate seamlessly within your robot companion, or even drive your car. And crucially, they won't just be rehashing information scraped from the internet. They will genuinely be thinking. So, what are your thoughts on this incredible development? Do you believe HRM represents the true future of artificial general intelligence? Share your insights and opinions in the comments below. I'm reading every single one. If you found this breakdown insightful and want more updates on groundbreaking AI breakthroughs like this, make sure to subscribe and give this video a like. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.